All right, this is fourth grade, module 6, lesson 1, and in this lesson, students are going to be using the metric measurement system to connect the decimals, tenths, with the fractions, tenths. So let's get started.
So what we've got here is this tape diagram broken up into 10 pieces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we're going to count by tenths, and we're going to label each of these pieces, and we're going to label it using a fraction and a decimal. Now, here's the interesting thing. Because we're taking that tape diagram where we historically record, like, the fraction inside, so we might say this is 1/10, and this is 1/10, etc. So we're going to, instead of having it beyond the spaces, so to speak, we're going to actually be connecting it with a number line, which means we're going to put those fractions on the hash marks, because we really want to relate it not to the tape diagram where we're kind of indicating the spaces, but we want to connect it with a number line where we're going to indicate the hash marks. So I'm going to delete those tenths because I don't want them there. And so the first thing the directions say is shade in the first 4 units of the tape diagram. So we will do that. We will shade in first 4. So there is our shade. So we've shaded in the first 4. And now we're going to count by count to label. So we know that this is 0.2, and this is 0.3, and this is 0.4. And then, so what are our fractions going to look like? Well, it's 1/10, and then it's going to be 2/10, and then 3/10, and then 4/10. So we want students to be able to look at this decimal, for example, 4/10, and we want them to recognize that 4/10, 0.4, and saying 4/10 are synonymous, that 0.4 and 4/10. When we say 0.4 and when we say 4/10 might mean this or it might mean this, but they are equivalent. They are the same value. And so let's go ahead and continue finishing off our decimal. So we've got 0.5, which is exactly halfway. That's kind of a classic thing that a lot of students in fourth grade would know. And then we've got 0.6. And then 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and we don't have 0.10, we have 1, because after 9/10 becomes 10/10, which is equal to 1. So this is 9/10, this is 8/10, this is 7/10, this is 6/10, and 5/10. So we've connected the decimals to the fractions so that when a student says, oh, 0.6, we want them to immediately know that that is equal to 6/10. And at this point, we're not worrying about reducing or simplifying fractions. So this is the kind of equivalence that we want students to immediately begin to recognize. Now, the one thing I forgot to mention is circle the decimal that represents the shaded part. So the decimal that represents the shaded part is right here. It is 0.4 or 4/10. Now here it says write the total amount of water in here as a fraction and then as a decimal. So I'm going to just kind of zoom into this first bottle right here, and we are going to write it as a fraction. So the first thing, we're going to start down here, and we're going to notice that that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 10 portions all together. So our denominator is 10. And the section that is shaded is up here. So that, we're going to count, and that gives us 7. So because here's 5, 6, 7. So our numerator is 7. So 7/10 of a liter. And how do we write that as a decimal? We write that as 0.7, and that's 7/10. Now I'm not going to do the rest of these problems because They're just the same as that first one. More practice connecting decimals to fractions. So write the total weight of food on each scale in fraction form here and then in decimal form here. So we've been given the decimal. So what is the fraction? In this case, it's 7/10. And then over here, we've been given the fraction, which is 6/10. So what is the decimal? It is 0.6. All right. And we are just connecting the decimal, in this case, oh, let's write 0.4, with its equivalent fraction. And at this point, we're not worrying about simplifying those fractions. Now here, we want to make sure we understand, kind of like a number bond. If you look at this 1 centimeter right here, so let's think of it as a number bond. So you've got 1 centimeter, and we know that one of those number bonds is 4/10, one of those portions. So the idea is, what is this missing part here to equal one whole? So the idea is, oh, that is 6/10, because 4/10 plus 6/10 equals 10/10, and that's our one whole. So what's the missing value? The missing value is 6/10 of a centimeter. Going straight across, we're going to write it as a decimal. So you've got 4/10 becomes 0.4 plus something equals 1 or 1.0. And so what is 6/10 as a decimal? That's 0.6. And the rest of these problems are the exact same. It may help students to write a number bond in order to find the missing value, but I think students can do it without the number bond. And then the last slide for this video is, we have these three piles. You have in unit form, using words, you have in fraction form, and you have in decimal form. And the idea is, let's make the connections. So if you've got 4/10, where is that going to go? Well, 4/10 goes up here, and which goes straight right here. How about 6/10? Well, here's 6/10. Where is 6/10? Oh, it's right here. So 6/10 goes here, and then 6/10 goes way up here. And you get the idea with the rest of this video. It's just connecting your unit form with a fraction with the decimal. And that wraps up 4th grade Module 6, Lesson 1, using that metric model, the metric measurement system, to connect the fraction to the decimal.